At its heart, Microsoft Stream has some functionality that proved to be really important to the program. Videos in Stream can be shared for permission at permission levels on a per video basis. So you can check the box to allow everybody in the company to view the video, or the individual group that created it is given permissions, or the person that recorded it is given permissions. And you can add permissions on a user by user basis if you want to. But the problem with this is that that's a cumbersome way to give access to 450 plus students. So we turn to channels. Channels in Microsoft Teams give you the ability to define sort of a category of videos, right? And individual users can choose to follow a channel so that, just like in YouTube, they will be notified as new videos are posted into it, or a channel can be integrated into Microsoft Teams. So it was the combination of both channels and Teams that made our video library really viable for Skills for Rhode Island's Skills Village. If you go into the video archives, this is where we sent students who missed a session. In video archives, there's a tab for session recordings. You'll notice that this tab auto-populates a library of all the videos that were published to that channel. This is a native functionality of the Stream Teams integration. So when you go into adding a tab in Teams and you choose to add a Microsoft Stream, you can choose either to publish a video, or you can say, I'm going to publish a channel. Every video posted to the channel automatically provides permissions to anybody that wants to view it based on where that channel is published. So because everybody has access to the convention center, it inherits those permissions. So it became very, very simple. All anybody needed to do of the 20 administrators that we had was conduct a meeting in whatever platform they wanted to conduct it in, get a copy of the recording, go into Microsoft Stream, and right here in the upper right-hand corner, click upload a video, drag and drop the file. Once the file was in their content, they could simply go in and say, I am going to share this with a channel. And by selecting the recordings, session recordings, just type in the word session, here's session recordings, it's a company-wide channel. The permissions are automatically set. Just by doing that and clicking apply, this video, Team 9 QR code demo, is now published against our Microsoft Teams channel.